take some bit of time over. Now you see, we are starting with this one, the library statistics. If you can't hear me, so there might be some bit of problem regarding audio. There might be some problem regarding audio because the internet connection is rather slow. So I'm also now getting something because, see, on Sunday, I do not know whether something happens in our area, and that's why we are not getting internet very properly, but still. So now, the library statistics, we are starting with that one. So you are seeing that thing, that is, I'm showing you a slide, that's because this is the first class. So let's start with that. Now, what is library statistics? Library statistics in that perspective is rather a vague term. This is usually the use of statistics, statistical method in libraries. So different types of statistical methods, you know, regarding this graphical representation, as well as the mathematical or statistical representations are there. Practically all fields, libraries also not an exception. We can apply that one in botany, which is known as biostatistics, and then geology, then other disciplines like commerce, mathematics. Everywhere you will see that one, there is the use of statistics. So that's why we are starting with that one, the library statistics. What is statistics? Statistics in general, that is nothing but the graphical representation of data. Graphical representation of data. Now, what is the graphical representation? So this might be graphical or mathematical representation of data. It's not that always it will be the graphical representation, but actually with the help of statistics, we try to reflect the data in tabular form. We try to reflect the data in, you see, pie diagrams, or rather you can say the bar diagrams, charts, everything. So this is what the purpose of statistics is. Now, now see, what does it actually mean? So first thing is that statistics, the word, it actually came from a Latin word known as status. The status, it refers to a method of dealing with quantitative information involving collection, analysis, presentation, and interpretation of data. Okay, so if you go for the statistics, you see these four things are important. It is rather the collection of data, analysis of data, presentation of data, and presentation of data and interpretation of data. What is this? So these four is important. Collection, analysis, presentation, and interpretation of data. This is the, or these are the criteria, or rather you see the components. These are the essential functions of statistics: collection, analysis, presentation, and interpretation of data. Now, data can be the raw data, that is the primary data. You can go to the field and you can collect the data, or the data can be the secondary data, that is already the data is there somewhere in data is already there, that is somewhere in, you see, that is in secondary sources like books, as because as for example we can say that on the census report. So where the census report, where the data is already there, if you take the data from the census report and then if you go for analyzing that data, that is one of the secondary data. And primary data is what? Primary data is the data what you collect from the field. Whenever you are going for collecting the data from the field itself, so then it is known as primary data. We'll deal with that one later. So now what we are going to see, so I told you that one, statistics is having that one, the collection, analysis, presentation, and interpretation. And you know, this statistics was originated in 18th century. Okay, so with the use of statistics, what do we try to represent? We try to represent the quantitative information, the collection of quantitative information, analysis of this one, presentation of this one, and interpretation of this one. Okay. Now, next is, see, the characteristics of statistics. You see, it is the facts and figures which are presented in tabular or other form. Tabular, that is a table-like structure. It is the facts or figures which are presented in a tabular or other forms. Okay. And at the same time, it is also regarded as one of the important tools for making decisions. Decision making is also one important tool for decision making. So this is what the first fact characteristics is, that it actually gives us a tabular or other forms of data, and then it helps us for decision making. Next is, now see the objectives of statistics. What are the objectives of statistics? Now for the library, it helps to determine the growth of library. It helps to determine the growth of library. Now how? That is what, whenever you are rather showing your activities in a library to the authority, you cannot say the authority that what you did in a particular year and your each and every day what you did in the library, you cannot say that one. The whole description you cannot give to the authority because they do not have that much of time. They want the result. And once they want the result, So you can show them, that is in a tabular form, what you did during the year, that is how many documents you collected in a particular year, then how many new people were inducted in the library, what are the different types of activities you did in your library. So ultimately that will help the administration to take a decision, and that's why I told you in the last slide or the previous slide, that is, it is helping for decision making, and then you will get another budget allocation or like that. So objective of statistics is it helps to determine growth of the library. Second, it helps to the librarian for comparison between previous and current years library activity. Previous and current years. Previous year what you did and current year what you are actually doing. It helps in controlling all the activities. Controlling all the activities. It helps to librarian evaluation for the staff performance. Then it helps to write the history and reports of the library. Annual report. You know, in BLIS you studied annual report. The planning, controlling, it helps with the help of statistics. It also helps us to compare a particular library with other library. How will you do it? This is also the thing, that is, you can go for comparing that one. Next, so now see sources of library statistics. Now, what are the different sources of library statistics? The sources. Okay. Still people are coming. Now, from where you can get that one? The diaries. Diaries means if the employees have diaries, what they did each and every day. So you can, this might be your source. Now see the janitor record. Whenever you go to the library, you generally sign in a book or rather register. That can be your daily, monthly and quarterly reports. Then get register. That one is the janitor's. Written documents in a library. How many documents were issued in a particular day throughout the year. Then library software. So all these things, these are actually the helpful thing for making the library statistics. Okay. Next one. Now see scope of library statistics. Where you can apply library statistics. You can apply library statistics in the acquisition section. This is what, where actually you collect the book, procure book, all these things. In processing section, cataloging, and classification section, in circulation section, in periodical section, in reference section. Here you can use this one. That is, you can, this is the use of statistics can be done virtually almost all subsystems of the library. Okay, this is possible. So this is all subsystems of the library. This is possible. So you can go for this one. So I think this is rather a quick glimpse of what we can do by applying statistics in the library. And right now it is actually my turn to see whether you are getting or not. Okay. So now, first of all, so I want to check that one. That is, I will come to that one again. Now, this is what I want to know, that one, whether you people are getting that thing or not. So everyone, I'm getting that one. That is, there is this one, Anushya. Are you getting me? Getting me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Sampadahar. Getting me? Prabhasundas?
Yes, sir.
Audio is right. Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Then Jovita.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Vibo means that one. Vibo's 1606. Vibo 1606. Okay, then Sushmita, you are getting that one. Forgetting me?
Yes,
okay, fine.
Yes,
Galaxy Grand Prime G, that is Niharika Roy. Niharika. This is the Galaxy Tab A, okay. Rima Chetri, it's okay. This one is Shakita Ghosh, Janu. I am not getting who is Janu. It's okay then. It's okay. Rituparna is here, okay. Video not available. Okay. So now you see. What we talked about, that is the statistics. First one is statistics is a branch of mathematics by which we try to represent quantitative data using graphical or tabular or mathematical form. That is what I told you. First thing, statistics. Now, statistics is nothing but the collection of raw data, interpreting, analyzing of raw data, interpreting the raw data and presenting the raw data. Okay. Data can be of two types. One type of data that you can collect by going to the field directly, and another type of data you can collect from the secondary sources like books, or rather already the data is already collected by someone and you are using that data. Like that one, you see the census data, that is government has already collected the data, you are consulting the census and you are using it. But in case of, see, for the libraries, whenever you are, if you go for a library survey, all the libraries in Siliguri subdivision, if you go for that one, so that will be the primary data, because you will go to the library and you will collect the raw data. And from that raw data, you can develop some kind of charts, bar diagram, histogram, pie diagram, charts, as well as you can go for the different statistical methods you can use, like mean, median, mode. That I will come later, courses of time or rather, wherever classes will be going on, I will go for that. So now, statistics is having a very, very, very good figure. What is that? Now see, right now we are talking, I am talking with you, you are rather also corresponding or reciprocating. But the problem is, if our, suppose I have to submit this class, record of this class to the author. Now, it is not possible for me, or rather it is not possible for the authority to judge who you are. And if I give them the name of all of you who are actually right now taking this class, if I say that one, they won't bother with that one. They will simply ask me, show us what is the percentage of attendance on online class. Percentage of it. That is, what was the total number of students and how many students actually accepted this one, that is online class. So then we can make a percentage. And here what we can do, a bar chart, we can make a pie chart, a graphical or table. That is, our total student was 50, but only 29 was taken this class. So out of 50, 29, so then you can make a diagram or you can make a table. So just by seeing that table, the authority or that fellow, they will understand that one, what is the situation and how they are getting. So it is not narrative. It is rather some bit of a summarized representation of the data. And that is what the basic purpose of statistics. Okay. So basic purpose of Bhutu is also there. Oh, I'm getting Bhutu. Oh, smiling. Yes. Okay. After a long time, I see you. Oh, Bhutu, good. Very good. Okay.
Sir, me audio mein tha na, isliye.
हाँ
ऑडियो में था ना इसीलिए
अच्छा अच्छा ठीक है चलो जो हो रहा है ठीक है चलो साहित्य प्रियांग का भी है यहाँ पे कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं ठीक है तो हाउएवर इट्स अ गुड दैट इज सो आई सम ऑफ यू आई सॉ इन द लास्ट टाइम इन द यूनिवर्सिटी व्हेनेवर योर एग्जामिनेशन विल बी हेल्ड और नॉट संपदा आई एम आल्सो गेटिंग अनुशिया इज आल्सो गेटिंग दे वर इन ट्रबल प्रभाव वाज आल्सो देयर दे वर आस्किंग मी समथिंग But they were rather in a big trouble on that. I do not want to share what trouble was, but they faced it. I think that is a long time. I got them, but right now, better to see that one. You people are alive and you are having smile on your faces at the same time. You are keeping a good shape. And that is rather a good thing to see. Okay. So we are returning to our, that is post again. So this is what just let me share the screen again. So up to this we discussed, okay? Now basics. We are going for revisiting the basics. Okay. Now statistics, quantitative figures, known as data. Statistics is a science which deals with collection of data. Then organization of data or classification of data. Then presentation of data. Then see analysis of data. That was the thing I told you. Now interpretation, that is also that one, that interpretation of data. Data and statistics are not same as instrument. These are not same. Statistics is the representation, while the data is the ingredient for that representation. It is rather the spices or rather the ingredients, main things that is required for that one, okay? So data, example of data, you see number of farmers in a block. Okay, then you can go for that one that is. Okay. The rainfall over a period of time, area under paddy crop, total number of books in a library. These are rather considered as data. Now what are the functions of statistics? Now see, it simplifies complexity. That is, whenever you have to say a lot, but it is rather giving us the information in a nutshell in more presentable way. It helps in formulating suitable policies, facilitate comparison, and helps in forecasting. Now, where statistics are used? Statistics are used almost all activities, human activities, all human affairs, useful in the administration of states, industry, business, economic, research, banking, insurance, companies, everywhere. Everywhere it is important. Now, what are the limitations of statistics? Now say, the limitations of statistics. Statistical theories can be applied when there is variability in the experimental material. Variability, that is important. You have to understand this one, limitation. Now see, in the world, do you know how many lies are there in the world?
Sir,
In the world, how many lives are there? There are, in the world, there are three kinds of life. L-I-E-S, three kinds of lives. One is life. Second one is the blatant life, B-L-A-T-A-N-T, blatant life. And third one is the statistics. Okay. So in the world, there are three different types of lives. It is rather said in ironic way. It's not the truth. The first one is the lie, second one is the blatant lie, and the third one is the statistics. But it is not true in that sense. But statistics can be where the variable, when constant is there, you cannot apply statistics there. Constant in what sense? Human beings are having hands. This is constant. You cannot apply statistics. You must have some variable structure, a kind of variability, where the data or variable varies. Otherwise, everything will be static. That is what the statistics is. Now see, I am telling you one thing. Another one thing I am telling you right now, it is very important to understand the functioning of the Zoom. Okay, try to understand this one. Zoom, we are using the free aspect of Zoom because we are not actually, I have not taken membership or like that. So whenever we are using Zoom for a particular session, Zoom allows 40 minutes only. So whenever we are doing on this, everyone please may keep your microphone muted. Okay. If you may keep your microphone mute, then you can hear me. Otherwise, there will be the noise. Okay. Now see, this Zoom is giving only 40 minutes for a session. Continuously, you can go for 40 minutes. Otherwise, you cannot actually continue that one. They will simply disconnect you after 40 minutes. So what we will do, so right now they are giving me the warning, that is you have only 10 minutes left. Okay. They are giving the warning. So once they will disconnect, then I will reconnect again. You will also just reconnect with the same ID and password, no problem. The same thing. I will continue that one. So we will reconnect, then again we will get another 40 minutes. Okay. So that's for why, if it gets disconnected, don't think that one the thing is over. Try to reconnect and we'll continue that one. Okay. Now going for that one again. So statistics deals with only the aggregates or groups and not with the individual objects. You cannot apply an individual object. So you have to have some groups. You have to make some. What is the noise? Now statistical results are not always exact. Now you know that one very well, and I think you have seen this one specifically for the poll analysis, cephalogy that we call. That is exit poll analysis, where they use this statistical method, and ultimately what they forecast that one. After the result, you usually see that one, the results are not at par with what was forecasted. So that's why the statistical results are not exact, but this is what you can understand, a pattern on this. Statistical result gives you a kind of hint. Statistical result gives you, that is what can be done. Statistical results can be given. A kind of, you say, that is what is indication, one kind of indication what may come, but it is not exact. And then statistics can be misused, that I told you, the blatant lie or lie, that one lie, blatant lie, and statistics. And statistics can be misused many a time for that one, specifically in this program. You are seeing that one. Types of things are coming. Some governments are giving, one government is giving one set figure, another government is giving another figure. So this is what the statistics can be misused. And next one is the collection of data. Now see, before collection of data, although I'm saying you collection of data here, so I think one aspect I'm not covering here, that is the graphical representation of data. Graphical representation of data, I will cover that one in Monday, same time. Same time, tomorrow there will not be any class, but Monday again at 12 we'll meet and we'll do the class. On that day I will actually give you the examples of graphical representation of data. Okay, graphical representation of data. But right now we are going for the collection of data. What is this collection of data? Now see, data can be collected by using sampling methods or experimental methods. So before that one, I have to say you some basic things, and that's why I am right now stopping the sharing, that is PowerPoint, and I'm going to close contact meeting. Okay. Now see, first thing, that is, in statistics, data in computer, data means the bit of information, that is the smallest bit of information. But in statistics, data means the group of data, rather, it's not rather data regarding a particular individual. It is rather the data regarding a group. Group, more than one person. That is more than one individual, more than one organization, more than one objects. That is what the first thing, data. Now, let me tell you one example. Suppose you want to do some statistics in your class, right? Now you want to measure the height and age of all MLIS first semester students, right? So you have to collect data, two types of data. One is the height, second one is the age, right? So what you can do, you can take a sheet, a paper, where the roll numbers are written, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. And one column is age, another column is height. Now what you can start, you can go to roll number one. You can ask him, tell me your age. He said that one. So suppose he has written 25. He said 25. Height 5.2 inch. So first data is collected. Now second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one. Like you collected all the data. Now here you see, you collected data of all 50 fellows. Okay? Data of 50 fellows. But you will see that one, if you see the column age, if you see the column age, then you will see there are several duplication of age. 25 is coming 5 or 6 times. 23 is coming 5 or 6 times. 27 is coming 5 or 6 times. This is what? Because the same age group, or rather having the same age, there might be more than one student. And the same for the height also, there might be more than one student. So now you started grouping them. Grouping in what? Out of 50 students, how many students are having age 0, that is 20 to 25? How many students are having age 25 to 30? And you are counting that. 20 to 25, suppose 16. 25 to 30, suppose 16. And then either will be, that is more than 30, or rather below 20. this is what by which we make group instincts. Regarding height also, who are below 5 feet? Who are above 5 feet? To make two groups, and see where the part of data, how data is rather collected. So first and foremost thing in statistics is under, because a video will be uploaded to YouTube, you know. So you can go to my YouTube channel. Already 4 or 5 videos are there. I uploaded videos of BLIS, I uploaded videos for PhD scholars, so this video will also be uploaded. Okay, because the university is asking that one whether we are taking classes or not. So this video is available for everyone throughout the world. It will be uploaded to YouTube so that people can also get this one, that is what we are doing here. So this is, that's for why. You have to keep a very grumpy face, or rather like that face. Okay, you can smile, but there is no point of rather that one, no smiling or rather that one, but you can. But aise harkat mat karo ki wo dekh ke khud hi uska problem aa jaye, uska statistics bigad jaye, ise kuch kaam mat karo. To theek hai, chalo. Ongita Bhattacharya charja wale kuner moddhe boshe ache. মৌমিতা ঘোষ অন্ধকারে ক্যামেরার সামনে ওকে নাও আই গট 26 পার্টিসিপেন্টস অল দ্য টাইমস দে আর জাস্ট এন্টারিং লেট মি স্টার্ট দিস ওকে So what I told you, that one first one is the data itself. I told you that one, how to collect data. Data means what? There must be, so now see one particular term came here, that is the concept of variable. Variable, whenever you are talking about statistics, two concepts are very important. One concept is known as constant, and second concept is variable. Two concepts, one is the constant and another one is the variable. Constant and variable, right? Now what is constant? Constant means value of which will never change. Like 2 + 2 means always 4. The value of any entity or object which will never change, that is known as constant. As for example, the value of pi, you know that one, the value of pi is fixed, 3.14. Okay, so the value, that is known as a constant. And you see, there are other things also where you see that one, there is this variable thing, like you see your age. Your age is a variable. Variable means value of which always changes. Value of an object, entity, which changes. That's why it is known as variable. It varies. Now you see, your time is always a kind of variable which will always increase. A kind of plus variable. Your variable is the plus variable, age. Because you will see that one, your age is having a kind of plus variable, means it will always increase. Every time your age will be increased. If you take the concept of seconds, now see what your age was before starting of this seminar, or rather before starting of this class. Right now you are rather aged for more 40 minutes. Get the point? More 40 minutes. This is a variable. Now you see your height. At your early age, this was variable, but after a particular age, this becomes constant. मानो कि राइट नाउ इफ आई हैमर यू, इफ आई स्ट्रेच यू फ्रॉम योर लेग एंड फ्रॉम योर दैट इज शोल्डर और दैट इज दैट्स एक्चुअली द हेड इटसेल्फ, इफ वी पुल फ्रॉम टू एंड्स इन सच ए काइंड एज सच ए फोर्स इवन यू विल सी दैट वन विल नेवर बी rather your height will never increase. So this is a constant. Can you tell me one thing where the value of the variable decreases if you pull? If you pull value of that particular object entity gets reduced. हम लोग हर टाइम देखा कि देखो ईच एंड एवरी टाइम वी सॉ दैट वन वैल्यू ऑफ द वेरिएबल इज रादर एन इंक्रीजिंग वन और रादर इट चेंजेस. ओके, चेंजेस मीन समटाइम बैड, समटाइम्स समटाइम्स पॉजिटिव, समटाइम्स नेगेटिव. सपोज ए काइंड ऑफ टर्मिनली इल पेशेंट, टुडे गुड, नेक्स्ट डे बैड. यू नो इन कोरोना क्राइसिस यू हैव सीन सेवरल पेशेंट्स, डॉक्टर्स आर सेइंग दैट हिज कंडीशन इज स्टेबल. And then in the afternoon we say that he is rather in coma like that. This is a variable. That is situation, sometimes this end, sometimes this end. But can you, and you see your age, this is rather, always it will advance. Okay, it will actually go up. And your height, after this particular point of time, it will stop. Can you tell me the name of one object where if you pull it, the value will decrease? No, the object is cigarette. See, here the size of the variable is rather constant, but if you pull it, obviously with light or rather fire, you'll see that one, it will be reduced. Get it? So this is what, this is also a variable. So this is what we use. First thing is that you have to understand regarding the very concept of variable. So variable means one concept where the value of which always change, and constant is such a kind of thing where value of that one never changes. So if you see your surroundings, you will always see that on most of the things, very few things are rather constant. Most of the things are variable. Right now you say no food shop is open, public food shop is open. If you go to Zomato and if you go for ordering, you will see that one, they have already high. And whenever you will go to, because whenever those restaurants will open, you go there, you will see that one, their value will decrease. So this is what, every time it happens, you know, this one, the variable. So society itself is rather a variable. So this one is the first one. And here comes two concepts, another two concepts. One concept is known as sample. Second concept is known as population. First one is population, right? First one is population. Don't yawn. First one is population, and second one is the sample. What is population? This population has no relationship with demography. This population is something, it's not having the relationship with demography. Population here means the total number of objects. Total number of objects. This is known as population. Total number of objects known as population. Now, total number of objects means what? As for example, if you say North Bengal University, students of the North Bengal University. This means the population, all students, all registered students. Or if you say or registered or ongoing students of North Bengal University, then all the students right now having the studentship in the North Bengal University for this particular year or semester. It's not that you can count those who are already, those who have already been passed. So this is what everybody is saying, birds. Hello. Whenever you were saying birds, we are talking about population. Population means bird. This very term is rather giving you the connotation. All birds of the world. Whenever you were saying birds in Siliguri, all birds in Siliguri. So this is population. Population means the whole aspect of the object. The total amount of object. Right? Totality of the object. And sample means a representation of the population. Sample is nothing but a representation of the population. What is the representation of the population? Representation of the population means, Manuki, if I say you, go to for your dissertation work or for your pilot project or for your any kind of that is class project, go to each and every student of our university. If I say this is a population, you can say that to answer it is not possible. Many times the students are not coming, many students or all the students are not coming each and every day. So how many people we can meet, or rather how many students I can meet? It may not be possible. Okay, so that's why. So then I can say you that one, okay, if you can't go to all the students, better take a portion of it, like 50%, 25%, 10%. This 10, 20, 50, but there is a mathematical formula for choosing the right sample. It's not actually that much of arbitrary, like 10, 20, 30. But whenever you are representing, you are taking one sample of it, or rather a portion of it, using a particular mathematical formula. I will tell you that one later. But 10%, Manuki is time clear. Right now, you just think that one, 10% of total population. So if total number of students in university is 2500, then your sample will be 250. That is 10% of total. That is 250. So you have to go to 250 people for collecting the data, and that is known as sample. So we try to represent the whole population with the help of samples. And that is why I told you statistics may not give you true result, because this 10% may not reflect the real view of the remaining 90% whom you didn't took into account for your study itself. So this is what, but still, this is what the sample is. So you got two aspects now. Rather you tell me that one, where is the problem? If you have any kind of problem, you better ask me. Anyone who got getting that one, just ask me where to get started. Everyone, fine, it's okay?
Sir, Ankita Bhattacharjo. Sir, sources of library statistics, what I have to tell you? Sources of library statistics.
Sources of library statistics say what we told, that is the diaries. Tiki Bolechi, diaries. Then this one, Eta. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Okay.
Hi, sir. Sources of library statistics. Hi, sir.
Eta, dekha jacche na?
হ্যাঁ স্যার দেখা যাচ্ছে স্যার
এইটাই ঠিক আছে দ্য ফার্স্ট ওয়ান ইজ দ্য ডায়েরি হোয়াট ইজ ডায়েরি ডায়েরিজ মিন্স সোর্সেস অফ লাইব্রেরি স্ট্যাটিস্টিক্স ওয়ার সে ডায়েরিজ আর নাথিং বাট দ্য জব রেকর্ডস হোয়াট ইউ ডিড ইচ এন্ড এভরি ডে many of the libraries they do not actually keep this one but what is that how many documents were processed by one individual suppose you have written that one. during the whole year how many documents you classified how many documents you catalog how many books you cataloged how many books you classified how many books you issued records of this is what can be written in diaries or rather it can be kept in daily weekly monthly and quarterly reports right first thing is that second is get registered that is how many people are rather coming to the library each and every day you know the janitor record in our library also at the gate one fellow is rather there who is sitting and in front of him one register is there where you have to put your signature And that is what known as get registered. By seeing this one, you can see how many people are rather coming to the library. Ever that, এটা তে কেনো important? Get registered এ দেখা গেল প্রতিদিন 200 জন করে ঢুকছে। Hello. আর সেক্ষেত্রে বই ইস্যু হচ্ছে 40। তাহলে আমি ইস্যু করছে 40। কারণ আমার ইস্যু কাউন্টারেরও আমার গেট পাস আছে। ওটা কাউন্ট করলেই আমি বুঝতে পারবো কতটা বই ইস্যু হয়েছে তাহলে আমি সঙ্গে সঙ্গে এখান থেকে স্ট্যাটিস্টিক্সটা ড্র করতে পারছি যে প্রতিদিন 200 করে ঢোকে 40 জন 40টা করে বই ইস্যু তাহলে বাকিরা কোথায় তাহলে একটা হতে পারে বাকিরা হতে পারে জার্নাল সেকশনে যায় তাহলে এবার আমি যদি হাবের রেকর্ডটা দেখি জার্নাল সেকশনেরটা দেখি যদি এটা দেখি যে তিনটে যোগ করে আমার 200 বেশি হচ্ছে তাহলে আমি গেটে যে বসে আছে তাকে চেঁচামেচি করতে পারি সবাই সই করছে না তুমি দেখছো না দিস ইজ হোয়াট দ্য রেকর্ডস দ্যাট ইজ এন্ড রিটেন ডকুমেন্টস অফ লাইব্রেরি রিটেন ডকুমেন্টস ইন লাইব্রেরি মিন্স কতগুলো অর্ডার আমি বইয়ের দিয়েছি রিটেন ডকুমেন্টস কতজন ছুটি নিয়েছে তোর চোর 10টা ছুটি নেওয়ার কথা 25টা নিয়ে বসে আছিস কে দিয়েছে তোকে এই ছুটি তোর বেতন কত কাটতে হবে এইগুলো হচ্ছে এন্ড লাইব্রেরি সফটওয়্যার কতগুলো বই লাইব্রেরি সফটওয়্যার অলরেডি ঢোকানো হলো কতগুলো হলো না ইস্যু কথা হচ্ছে সো দিস আর দ্য ডিফারেন্ট সো এইটাই যে শুধু তাই নয় এর মধ্যে আরো অনেক কিছু থাকতে পারে ইউজার কে তুই দেখলি সাপোজ ইউজার্স আর কামিং ওভার देयर এন্ড ইউ আর টেকিং দ্য ইউজার্স এক্সপ্লেন অর দ্য ইউজার্স ভিউ রিগার্ডিং দ্য লাইফ ইউ ক্যান কিপ দ্যাট ওয়ান whether he is satisfied or not did you get your book yes are you satisfied yes so you can keep record of this and at the same time you can prepare some kind of graph that is how many people are satisfied how many people are not satisfied so like that so this is what the statistics are okay
yes sir ha bujheche sir
bujhechi acha okay so with this so our today's class is over so next class will be on Monday same time same day it's not day same time or rather different day so thank you very much so again
okay, sir, thank you
on Monday sir. At
thank you sir
thank you sir
thank you sir
thank you sir